Okay, welcome to Chapter 4, Immune. Vancomycin, MRSA, and C. diff, that's methicillin-resistant Staph aureus and Clostridium difficile. We'll talk about a little bit as well. So the four drugs we're going to use, and I put vancomycin in some resistant infections. Penicillin, so amoxicillin, we're bringing that back, and I'm going to talk a little bit about methicillin, brand Staphcillin. They don't make it anymore, as I understand, but it's useful to talk a little bit about the history. Oxazolidinone, linezolid, brand Zyvox, the lincosamide, clindamycin, brand Cleosin, and the glycopeptide, vancomycin, vancosin. Again, the stems are cillin for the penicillin, zolid for the oxazolidinone, mycin for the lincosamide, but that just tells you it's from streptomyces strain, same as the glycopeptide vancomycin. So practice question one, just looking at the drug classes, and if methicillin, brand Staphcillin, is beta-lactamase resistant, which antibiotic is beta-lactamase sensitive? Select all that apply. And A, the beta-lactam aminopenicillin antibiotic, amoxicillin, is beta-lactamase sensitive. That is, that enzyme that attacks the beta-lactam ring will destroy the aminopenicillin. The other ones are not beta-lactam antibiotics. So that begs the question, you know, what are these other ones good for, and what are the issues that we're going to see with them? Because these don't really group nicely the way that penicillins have amoxicillin and ampicillin and so forth, and we'll see that in a minute. Okay, so there's the answer. The beta-lactam aminopenicillin antibiotic, amoxicillin, is beta-lactamase sensitive. But let's go to the drug names, because that's what we're really going to see on the exam. So if methicillin is beta-lactamase resistant, which is beta-lactamase sensitive, and amoxicillin, now without the clavulanate or without the clavulanic acid as augmentin, would be beta-lactamase sensitive. And then clindamycin, linezolid, vancomycin, not beta-lactam antibiotics. But vancomycin does affect the cell wall, as do penicillins and cephalosporins. They just do it in a different way. And the reason that vancomycin works where penicillins fail is that they don't use the penicillin binding proteins as their mechanism of action. They use an alternate mechanism of action disrupting the bacterial cell wall. Okay. So our drugs again, amoxicillin, clindamycin, linezolid, and vancomycin. So let's make B correct. Practice question three. Which of the following antibiotics is most likely to result in Clostridium difficile associated diarrhea, CDAD? And clindamycin is notorious for this. While amoxicillin and penicillins are broad spectrum, it's less likely. And linezolid actually would be a possible treatment for C. diff. And then vancomycin is a treatment that's recognized for Clostridium difficile. Practice question four, make C correct. Which of the following antibiotics can treat both vancomycin-resistant enterococci, VRE, and methicillin-resistant Staph aureus, MRSA? Now, it's kind of giving it away because on an exam, you would likely see VRE and MRSA without the actual organisms spelled out. So amoxicillin, no. Clindamycin, no. They're not going to do that. But linezolid, yes, this is both good against vancomycin-resistant enterococci, and it's also good against MRSA, methicillin-resistant Staph aureus. Vancomycin would be one of those, it's partially right, so it's wrong. So if something is vancomycin resistant, obviously vancomycin is not going to work, but it does work against MRSA. So because it's partly right, it doesn't answer the question properly. And then the last one is one of those questions where this is common knowledge. It's expected that when you hear red man syndrome, the first thing you're going to think is vanc. So practice question five, make D correct. Which of the following antibiotics is associated with the infusion-related reaction, red man syndrome? Select all that apply. And in this case, vancomycin, yes, it involves this erythematous rash in the neck, the torso, it's all over. And then pruritus as well, which loosely translate to hives. But again, this is an infusion-related reaction. So, but this is something that as soon as you see red man syndrome, immediately you should think vancomycin, or vice versa. You hear vancomycin, you should see a red man syndrome. So amoxicillin, again, this is beta-lactamase sensitive. Clindamycin, you're going to see CDAD with that one. Linezolid, it's good for VRE and MRSA. Vancomycin, it's good for MRSA, but we're going to have this very unique side effect or reaction of Redman syndrome as an infusion-related reaction.